Hi, this is Manos Brilakis, and this is case 121 for the Manual of Percutaneous Coronary Interventions. This is a case illustrating several challenges for treating a right coronary artery in a patient with previous heart transplant. Engaging the coronaries was challenging, and this is why. This is a catheter coming from the descending aorta up in the ascending aorta. Actually, this patient has a right-sided aortic arch, which is a variation of normal, and as you will see, it made engagement of the coronary arteries quite challenging. This was the initial presentation. The patient has had multiple PCIs of the right coronary artery and presented with in-stent restenosis. He did have multiple areas of restenosis within the previous stents, and those were undilatable. There was multiple inflations with several balloons, including plaque modification balloons, that failed to expand those lesions. Engaging with the guide was very challenging, so what was done eventually is engage the coronary with a diagnostic Williams and then advance a grand slam, which is a supportive guide wire, into the right coronary artery, and then we advanced a guide catheter over the grand slam wire until it successfully engaged the right coronary artery. This is a nice solution to employ when there is difficulty engaging, because the diagnostic catheters have thicker walls and are more torqueable than the guide catheters that have thinner walls. In this patient, we did the orbital atherectomy as well as intravascular lithotripsy off-label with a peripheral catheter, and that improved, although it did not make perfect, the undilatable lesions in the right coronary artery. Unfortunately, the patient came a year later with inferior ST segment elevation myocardial infarction, and once again, there is difficulty engaging the right coronary artery. However, now the RCA appears to be occluded. After trying multiple guide catheters, eventually there was selective engagement, confirming once again the occlusion of the right coronary artery. So this is a case of acute stent thrombosis. There was no significant lesion on the left coronary system. So balloon angioplasty was done after wiring through the right coronary artery stents, but there was no restoration of flow. Then increasingly larger balloons were used. The thought of maybe we have too much thrombus into the coronary artery, or maybe there is a lot of restenosis that needs to be taken care of. But unfortunately, there was still no flow. The next step was to do thrombectomy. Thrombectomy was done using an export aspiration catheter as well as the penumbra system. And unfortunately, there was no restoration of flow. There was not really much aspirated except for blood, and there was no change in flow. So eventually we did intravascular ultrasound that does demonstrate that actually the stent seems to be patent. There is some tissue inside that could be neointima or could also be thrombus. And then as we move more proximally, there is still an area of stent under expansion that was present there even after atherectomy, as well as intravascular lithotripsy. After multiple attempts that took several hours, multiple balloon angioplasties, vasodilator administration, as well as thrombectomy, eventually attempts to recanalize the RCA were abandoned. So several lessons from this case. The first one is that having a right-sided aortic arch can make engagement of the coronary arteries more challenging. In patients who have balloon dilatable lesions, there are several ways to try to expand them, including atherectomy, both orbital and rotational, including laser with contrast, as well as now including intravascular lithotripsy. But unfortunately, those were not successful. There was some expansion, but not perfect, of the right coronary artery. And then having an underexpanded stent is a risk factor for both restenosis and stent thrombosis, as happened in this patient. When there is an acute stent thrombosis, treatment is usually with balloon angioplasty, sometimes thrombectomy, administration of vasodilators, and aggressive antiplatelet therapy such as glycoprotein to B3 inhibitors or cangrelor. But in this particular case, despite using all these methods, it was not possible to restore antegrade flow in the right coronary artery. Thank you.